The FIFA Player Career Mode. The mode that has seen the least amount of changes over the years. But the mode does have potential, and it can definitely be improved. Hello guys, my name is Falanon, and I actually graduated writing my final paper on this mode's potential improvements. In order to know how something game design related can be improved, we first need to look at what is wrong with it at this moment. What frustrates us? What is it that we miss? Let's start with the basics. In a player career mode, you, the gamer, are controlling your own virtual player. You play your matches, experience growth, and achieve to complete your upcoming targets. And who knows? If you do well enough, you might even get yourself a transfer to your dream club. But do you feel like you are a professional football player? Do you feel like your actions change the game world? Do you feel like you are part of a team? Do you even feel like your player is actually you? Let's talk about immersion, a perception of being physically present in a non-physical world. Maher writes the following: giving gamers the opportunity to choose reactions to events makes a character's reactions and behavior more in line with the gamers themselves. And the more details the gamer feels he is putting into the game, as opposed to the game putting into the character, the greater the sense of personal immersion. But what can our players do in this player career mode? Well, we can play matches, ask for a transfer, and handle the transfer offers we receive. We have to make a lot of decisions while we're playing a match, but outside of matches, there are almost none. Although we, the gamers, can decide how our virtual player will look, we cannot decide his personality and behavior. One of the most important features of personal immersion is that the character should respond exactly how the gamer feels like responding. In any situation, the gamer should determine his character's behavior. Take a look at real life. Professional football players are interacting all the time. They interact with other players, managers, coaches, agents, the press, need I go on. In the player career mode, we cannot interact with others. At all. FIFA tries to at least enhance immersion by having the press write about our player. However, these messages feel generic and repetitive. And it gets even worse. Sometimes you might see a press message coming along in which quotes of your player can be found, and you might not agree with what your player is saying. This detaches you from your character even more. The next thing I want to talk about is the growth system. Check out this clip from AA9Skills, who shares my thoughts on this.
It's too repetitive. It's too dumb. It makes you play a certain way. It makes you want to go for finesse shots from outside the box. It makes you want to do chip shots because that's what you have to do to unlock accomplishments. And to me, that's not really realistic.
I fully agree with AA9 here. And although some gamers do like the current growth system, I think I know how to make it better. The last thing I want to talk about is unrealistic occurrences. I will give you guys an example based on personal experience. I started off my career in the Dutch team, and they decided I should go out on loan. Even though I was on the loan list, I was playing all matches. As I was constantly playing, I decided to decline all offers of clubs wanting me. In the winter transfer period, I was the top goal scorer and top assister of the league, but the management still wanted to loan me out. I even asked them to get me off the loan list, but even then the management decided to keep me on there. What? Enough said about this. This is just an example of an unrealistic occurrence, but things like these, big and small, are constantly happening in this career mode. And this breaks your immersion into the character even more. In order to believe you are the character, the world it inhabits needs to be believable as well. To sum it all up, immersion in the player career mode is broken down mostly due to unrealistic occurrences and repetitive messaging, while gamers lack control beyond playing matches and making the occasional transfer. But can it be made better? It definitely can. I will discuss some of my research solutions in part 2 and 3 of these series. Be sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss it and want to keep updated on new content. And give this video a thumbs up if you like this first part. I'll see you in the comments. I'm out.